Okay. Now, section 6.3, kernel and range. Okay. Now we will show that the subset of a domain which maps zero vector by a linear transformation become a subspace. Okay. Here. That is called kernel. Let T be a linear transformation. Then the set of all vectors in the domain whose image becomes a zero vector by T, then it is called the kernel of T. And it is denoted by kernel of T. So kernel of T is a set of vectors in the domain and whose images is a zero vector. So the kernel of T is in the domain and whose image is just one point, zero vector. Okay? So we call this is a kernel. That is a subspace. That's what we're going to show. Find the kernel of T for a linear transformation T, where T of x, y is equal to x minus y and 0. Then what's the kernel? Kernel is a set of vectors in the domain that satisfies this is a zero vector. If it is true, then x should be same as y. So it is a line. Straight line passes through the origin. This is a kernel of this linear transformation. Okay? Okay? So any of the vectors in this set goes to a zero vector by the linear transformation T. You see? So next, find the kernel of T where linear transformation T it looks like this. Okay, x1 goes to here, x2 goes to here, x3 goes to here, and x4 is gone. And the first component is going to be zero like this. Then, what is the kernel of this linear transformation? This should be a zero vector. So what? This should satisfy. So the all x1, x2, x3 should be what? Zero. So the set of vectors that x1, x2, and x3 are all zero. Then that's it. So any vectors in this set goes to a zero vector by a linear transformation T. Okay? Okay. And one to one. For a transformation T, if T of U is equal to T of V implies U is equal to V, then it is called one to one. 일대일, one to one. Or injective. 인젝티브. 여기가 두 개가 다르면 이미지도 달라야 되는 거예요. Okay, one to one. Next, onto, surjective. For a transformation T, if there exists V for any given W in the codomain, such that T of V is equal to W, then it is called onto, or surjective. For any, if you choose any vector in the codomain, then there is a pre-image in the domain all the time. Then we call it is onto surjective. If you choose anything from the codomain, then it always you can find the pre-image in the domain. Okay. If a linear transformation is one-to-one, then if and only if kernel of T should be a singleton set, zero is zero vector. Kernel of T should be only a set of zero vector if T is a linear transformation. Why? Suppose V is in the kernel of T, then we have to show what? We have to show that V should be a zero vector. That's what we're supposed to show. To show one direction. So T of V is what? Should be zero because V was chosen from the kernel of T. But also we know the image of a zero vector is a zero vector. So this should be same. But we have the condition that T is one to one. So T of V is equal to T of V implies V is equal to zero. But that means any vector in kernel of T should be a zero vector. There's no other vector. So that means kernel of T is a single, is only the set of zero vector. Next, if kernel of T is zero, then start with T of V1 is equal to T of 2. So suppose there are two vectors in kernel, V1 and V2, and T of V1 is equal to T of V2. And suppose for any vectors in V1 and V2 in the domain, then T of V is equal to T of V2, then what this says. If we move this one to the other, then zero is this. Since T is a linear transformation, this can be written in this way, which means V1 and V1 minus V2 is in the kernel of T. But kernel of T is only a singleton set, zero vector. So this V1 minus V2 should be a zero vector, which means V1 is equal to V2. So for any vector V1 and V2 in the domain, if you start with this, then you ended it as V1 is equal to V2, which means T is 1 to 1. So showing 1 to 1 for the linear transformation, all you have to do is just find the kernel. Check it. That's still do it. Okay, here's an example. Show this linear transformation T is 1 to 1. What you have to do? Find the kernel. Kernel of the T of X is equal to 0, which is YX is equal to 0, 0, which means Y should be 0, X should be 0, like this. So what this means is every vector in the kernel is a 0, is only a 0 vectors. So it's a singleton set of 0 vector, kernel is. So T should be 1 to 1. That's the way. Okay? Mm-hmm. Next, show is a linear transformation T whether is one to one or not if it is defined as this. Okay, so in order to show, we have to check the kernel, then find out the kernel. Let T of X Y Z is equal to zero vector. Then that gives us a linear system of equation, which can be simplified with this, which is a two equation with three unknowns, homogeneous system. So it should have a free variable. So it has a non-trivial solution, which means kernel cannot be a singleton set. Okay? It has infinite many solutions. So it cannot be one to one. Okay? So we can check it. If you define a variables and define a linear transformation, just check whether the linear transformation is one to one or injective or surjective. Then you can easily check it. Mm-hmm. If injective, then it gives you false. It's not injective. Find the kernel. If you ask to find the kernel with this command, T dot kernel, then it gives you a base for the kernel. So kernel is a scalar multiple of this, span of this vector. Okay? Next. Let A be an n by n matrix. If we define a linear transformation T as T of X is equal to AX, then kernel of T is a solution space of the system of linear equation AX is equal to 0. Kernel is a solution space, isn't it? Here. Yeah. Because kernel is what? The set of vectors in the domain that satisfies T of X is equal to 0, which is AX is equal to 0. So what is the solution for this? That's the solution space for AX is equal to 0. That's the kernel of T. Okay? So let Rn, Rm are vector spaces and T is a linear transformation from Rn to Rm. Then kernel of T is a subspace of Rn. Hence the subspace kernel is called just a kernel. Okay. Mm-hmm. So this is a subspace now. Why? Why? What do you have to show? What do you have to show? We want to show the set. The set kernel is a subspace. What's the condition? How many conditions we have to show? Whether the given set is a vector space or not, subspace or not. How many? First, what? It is closed under the vector addition. It is closed under the vector addition. That's all we have to show. So first, check it. For the first, choose arbitrary two vectors from the kernel and show V1 plus V2 is in the kernel. Okay? Next, choose a scalar and find and check whether the scalar multiple of the k multiple of V1 is in the kernel. That's all you have to do. So for the first, choose, suppose V1 and V2 are from kernel, then T of V1 is a zero vector, and T of V2 is a zero vector. Then what happened? T of, what about T of V1 plus V2? Since, because of the linearity, we can split it. This is a zero plus zero, which is a zero vector, which means V1 plus V2, the image of V1 plus V2 is a zero vector, so V1 plus V2 is in the kernel of T. Okay, next, for K, T V1, so from the linearity of the linear transformation, K come out, and T of V1 is a zero vector, so K times zero vector is a zero vector, which means K V1 is in the kernel because its image is a zero vector. So this kernel of T is closed under the vector addition and closed under the scalar multiplication. So it is a subspace of Rn, of the domain. Because we started with a subset kernel of T of a domain, and now we showed the two-step subspace test to show the subspace. It is a subspace. Find the kernel of T when T of X is equal to AX with A is this. Okay, find the kernel. How? All you have to do is find the matrix and find the kernel of A, then it gives you empty, like this. This means kernel has only a zero vectors. Or you can solve the linear system of equation, but this is much easier, isn't it? To find the kernel. Isomorphism. For a linear transformation T, the set of all T of V for V in Rn is called the image of T. And it's denoted by image of T. That is, image of T is the set of all the images. Okay. Especially, if image of T is the whole codomain, then T is called surjective or onto. Okay. And so here, isomorphism. If a linear transformation T is one-to-one and onto, then it should, the N should be same as M. Rn and Rm should have the same dimension. Okay. Then, and T is called an isomorphism from Rn to Rn. If we find a linear transformation T, which is one-to-one and onto, then means these two vector spaces should be have the same dimension, and we call they are isomorphic. And T is an isomorphism. Okay. One-to-one and onto, it means isomorphism for linear transformation. Find the range of the linear transformation. T of xy is equal to x minus y0. What's the range? What's the range? Image of T. What's the image of T? Which is range. Here, this is a set of images. So set of images is this. So here, x minus y and 0 and x, y. So what this means is, this is any vector, and the second component should be 0. So it can be written in this way. So this is the image. Okay? So it's this range. That's the range. The range is not same as R2, so it's not onto. Okay? It's not surjective. Next. So it's not, he's not an isomorphism because it's not onto, not surjective. Next, W1. This and W2. Think about these two. It is easy to see that these both W1 and W2 are subspace of R2, R4. And if we define T from W1 to W2, then the following linear transformation, this, is both one-to-one and onto. Can be easily shown, then T is now an isomorphism from W1 to W2. Okay. Got it? So these are two different subspaces of R4, but they are isomorphic. As you see, the structure of these two subspaces should be same. Only the position difference. Okay? Mm-hmm. We call they are isomorphic. And T is isomorphism. Okay, so for linear transformation T, image of T is also a subspace of Rm. Subspace in the codomain. Image. How you show? So here, what, how many things you have to show in order to show that it's a subspace? How many conditions? Two conditions. First, closed under vector addition. Second, what? Closed under scalar multiplication. Then, by two-step subspace test, it is going to be a subspace. So, for the first, choose arbitrary vectors from the image. Show addition is in the image. Okay? So, since W1 is in the image, so there exists a pre-image V1 in the domain. Okay? Since W2 is in the image, so there exists a pre-image V2 is in the domain. So there exists V1 and V2 that satisfies this, which implies this. T of V1 plus T of W1 plus W2 is what? T of V1 plus T of V2, isn't it? Which can be written as T of V1 plus V2, which means, and also V1 and V2 was in the domain. So what we have is T of V1 plus V2 is equal to W1 plus W2, and V1 plus V2 is in the domain, which means W1 and W2 has a pre-image in the domain Rm, which means vector addition still is in the image of T. So it is the image of T is closed under the vector addition. Any questions? Next. Mm-hmm. Yeah, question? Okay, so you got it now. So next, example 8. Let A be an M by M matrix. We define a linear transformation T. As T of X is equal to AX, then image of T is a column space of A. Image of A is just a column space of A. Why? Let A is, can be written as a column vectors. Then A of J, A to DJ, to be an M by N matrix, A is J's column vector. Then for any vector X in Rn, can be written as what? As a linear combination of these column vectors. Okay, which means any image can be expressed as a linear combination of column vectors of A. Any vector, since this is a, so it is image of T. Any vectors in the image of T can be written as AX, Y is equal to AX. Okay, so any vector Y in the image can be written as a linear combination of column vectors of A. That's what it says. Any image, any vectors in the image can be written as a linear combination of column vectors, which means image of T is itself for a span of column vectors. It's very important observation. 6, 3, 4. For a linear transformation T defined by a matrix, the following property. If TA is 1-to-1, then column vectors of A are linearly independent. If TA, which is a linear transformation, that's a matrix linear transformation, okay, then TA is 1-to if and only if row vectors of A are linearly independent. This easily can be shown. First, TA is 1-to-1, which means kernel of TA is 0 vector, and there is a unique X in Rn which satisfies AX is equal to 0, only 0 vector. Then n column vectors should be a linear independent. Mm-hmm. 그러니까 linear combination of column vectors. Okay? Is equal to zero. Has only trivial solution. Which means all CI's coefficient should be zero. So that means column vectors are linearly independent. Okay? 1차 결합. C1에 V1 플러스 C2 V2 equal 0 했더니 C1도 0, C2도 0, CN도 다 0가 되면 1차 독립이라고 하지. 네, 컬럼 벡터들의 1차 결합이 0 벡터인데 근데 그 0 벡터인데 그 솔루션이 CI가 다 0인 솔루션밖에 없다는 게 아니야. 트리벌 솔루션밖에 없으니까. 그러니까 그 벡터들이 1차 독립이 되는 것이 나오죠. Next. TA is onto, that means image of T is RM, whole core domain, then for A, for the jth column vector of A, then RM is the span of the column vectors, then which means in RREF of A, the number of leading variables should be N, M, should be M, should be M, because then row rank of A is M, which means M row vectors of A are linearly independent. 이게 m 벡터의 스팬이 rm이 된다는 소리는 rm 안에는 리딩 베리어블이 m개 있다는 소리지. rm m개밖에 없지. 더 많을 수가 없지. rm 안에 리딩 베리어블이 m보다 많을 수는 없지. m 차원인데 m 차원 공간인데. 그러니까 그러면 리딩 그러면 그 로우 랭크가 m 바이 n 매트릭스에서 m 바이 n 매트릭스에서 로우 랭크가 m이 된 소리 아니야? 그러면 m개 로우가 다 1차 독립이 된 소리잖아. 그러니까 M계의 로우가 다 1차 독립인 거지. 행렬 A의 로우 랭크가 다 풀 랭크라는 소리지. 그러니까 1차 독립이라는 소리죠. 오케이? Okay? So, if you, since, if image of T is Rm, then M rows of A are all linearly independent. Okay, here is the example. Verify the following, following that. If A is this, then TA is 1 to 1, but not onto. This is 3 by 2잖아. 3 by 2. So it is one, 위에 아이덴티티가 있고 이 제로가 있죠. It's a 1 to 1. 그러니까 3차원 벡터를 이쪽으로 각각 다른 걸 다른 거로 보내긴 하지. 1 to 1인 건 쉽게 보일 수 있지. 근데 디멘전, 로우 랭크가 몇이에요? 2지요? 로우가 다 1차 독립해야지 그 저기 그 온투가 되는데 이게 벌써 논 제로가 있으니까. 그렇죠? We can show it. We can show it by from the definition or from the properties that we showed. But you can ask it in this way. Define a matrix and define a linear transformation with that matrix. Then check the surjective. Okay, image of T. Whether T is surjective or not. Then it gives you the image and it shows you the answer which is not it is not a surjective matrix. Check injectivity. Ask it whether it is injective. Then it gives you yes. It is true. It is injective. Because kernel is only zero vector. T is defined in this way. This is onto, but not one-to-one. Row vector들은 1차 독립이죠. 그러니까 onto야. Column vector들은 1차 독립이 아니지. One-to-one이 될 수가 없는 거지. Okay? The row vector, from the theorem, row vectors are linearly independent, so it is onto. But column vectors are not linearly independent, so it cannot be onto one. You can do the same thing. If you ask, define a linear transformation, ask whether it is surjective, then it says true. Ask is injective, then it gives you the, it's not true. Next theorem, let A be an M by N matrix, then TA is a linear transformation, then TA is one-to-one, if and only if TA is onto. If domain and codomains are same, then one-to-one, if and only if onto. So if you have a linear transformation from V to V, then all you have to do is if you show the one-to-one or onto, if you show one of them, then you don't have to show the other. Okay? Because if it's one-to-one, then kernel is zero, then it has a unique solution, of AX is equal to zero, then RREF is the number of leading variables so in which is N. Then for the columns here, the image of T is also RN itself. So image of A is RN, so T of A is onto. It's one-to-one, if and only if statement. You can start from here, or you can start from here to show they are same. here, that's, this is last. Inverse matrix theorem. We already have this so far. We just added this two. If A is a non-singular matrix, its corresponding linear transformation is 1 to 1. And also corresponding linear transformation is on 2 if standard matrix A is non-singular. If it's non-singular, it has a n linearly independent columns and n linearly independent rows. So it's 1 to 1 and on 2. That's it. I think that's the end of section 6.3. And this is the first time the Korean team, Olympiad team, won the gold medal, the ranked number one in the whole world in mathematics competition. Okay, we'll continue section 6.4 for the next time. Any questions?